Hello everyone, and welcome back to our inventory system series in Godot 4. In the previous part, we started creating our hotbar and we created the functions to add and remove items to the hotbar, but we've not yet created any functionality to assign items to our hotbar. If we were to assign a slot with an item just as is, it would create duplicate values because we will be able to assign the same item multiple times to the hotbar. This will create an existing item in each available hotbar slot, even if that item has already been assigned to the hotbar and already exists. To prevent this, we'll need to create a way of monitoring our item assignment to see whether or not that item is assigned or not. So let's open up our project, and in our global script, let's create a new function which will prevent any duplicate assignment of our items in our hotbar. In this function, we will check each item in the hotbar inventory and return true if the item is found in the hotbar and false if the item is not found in the hotbar. Now back in our inventory slot script, we'll create a new Boolean variable that will keep track of our item assignment in our hotbar. With our Boolean created, we'll go ahead and create a new function that will update this Boolean value based on the value returned from our function that we just created in our global script. We'll also update our assign button's text whilst we're at it. So if the item is not assigned to the hotbar, the text should be assigned, but if it is assigned, it should be unassigned since we want to remove it from the hotbar. So now every time we set a new item in a slot, we'll need to call this function so that we can update its assignment and its text. Now, in our onAssignButtonPress signal function, we will first check if an item is in the slot before we do anything with it. If we are interacting with our hotbar, it means our isAssigned Boolean value is true, and the player is intending to remove the assigned item from the hotbar. So let's remove the item from our hotbar and reset our isAssigned Boolean back to false. If an item is not assigned to the slot, it means that we are interacting with our main inventory, and our player is intending to assign the item to our hotbar. So let's add an item to our hotbar. So So now after changing the assignment status of the item, we'll need to update our UI so that it can show the correct text. We will do this by calling our update assignment status function. We'll also need to update the hotbar UI back in our inventory hotbar script so that we can ensure that the correct text is shown on our hotbar itself and our hotbar item as well. Now, if you run your scene, open up your inventory, and assign an item to the hotbar, it should add, showing the item both in the main inventory and hotbar inventory. If you were to remove or use the item, it should update the quantity or remove it from both inventories. If you unassign the item, it should remove the item from the hotbar but remain in the main inventory. Finally, we'll need to create our shortcut keys to use these items. So our shortcut keys will be key 1 to 5 on our keyboard. So if we press key 1 on our keyboard, slot item 1 should be used. If we press 2, item 2 should be used, and so forth. So open up your input actions panel in your project settings and create a new input for each hotbar key that you want to create. Like I said, we'll use keys 1 to 5 on our keyboards for slot 1 to 5 on our hotbar. Now back in our player script, we'll need to create a new function that will allow us to execute certain logic when we press the shortcut keys. For our case, we will just apply the item effect and then decrease its quantity until the item is removed. Now to actually use the item by pressing keys 1 to 5, we will need to call our unhandled input function. We'll be using the unhandled input function for our shortcuts to ensure that our actions are globally accessible and it doesn't interfere with other inputs that have already been defined in other functions such as our normal input function. In this function, we'll first need to check if the input that is pressed is a key press event. We'll check this by calling the input event key method, which is a type of input event that corresponds to keyboard inputs. Since we have 5 inputs and 5 slots in our hotbar, we will loop through the hotbar slots. Then, inside this loop, we will check if a specific hotbar key is pressed. The keys are mapped to our actions that we just created, so we'll dynamically check the name of this input via the slot index. So slot 1 will create hotbar underscore 1, and slot 5 will create hotbar underscore 5, which are the inputs that we just created. And that's it. Now we can run our scene to test this out. If you assign items that have effects to them to all 5 slots, and you press 1 to 5 on your keyboard, the item should be used and the quantity should update and it should be removed if it reaches 0. And that is all for me for now. In the next video, I will show you how to make your inventories draggable and droppable so that we can reorganize our inventory to our liking. I just want to say sorry for being so inconsistent so far in January with my video upload schedule. I've just been running around like a headless chicken. I have so much to do, I have so much planned, and I just feel like I can't really get to everything. So I'm sorry, I'm doing my best, and I'll try to do better from here on out. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.